Thirdhand smoke is what you smell when you go into a hotel room where people have been smoking, or what rubs off on your skin if you touch a wall, or if you visit somebody's house and they've been smoking. So that means it's not only there in the air, but it's also coming out of the surfaces. So third-hand smoke is the residue of tobacco smoking that's in a building after people have smoked.
We call it the three R's. It remains. It doesn't go away. It reacts with other chemicals in the environment, and it also will be able to come back off of whatever it's stuck to, usually at a lower concentration. Studies have shown that even if an adult smoker, a parent, smokes only outdoors, their children have higher levels of exposure to smoke compounds, probably because of what sticks to their skin and their hands that they then bring indoors and expose their children to. I was studying the research that the tobacco industry had done on the toxicity of secondhand cigarette smoke. And one particular piece of research that they did was they emitted smoke into a room and then look at what happened to it.
It turned out the nicotine stuck to the walls. Not only that, nicotine would stick to, it'd be sucked up into materials like wallboard that we use commonly in this country. And it would be really hard to get it out, but it would diffuse out along with other compounds in the smoke. And that led to the interest of tobacco-related disease research program in finding out what health effects might be of exposure to what we now call third-hand smoke. One of the things that we're going to do at Berkeley Lab is to try to understand how third-hand smoke moves around in an actual room, and also understand how much is sucked up by building materials. We're also looking at the composition of third-hand smoke residues in more detail.
When you're living in a smoke-contaminated space, you're completely immersed in it. One of the things that really interests me about third-hand smoke is how it allows a lot of the ideas and paradigms of outdoor air pollution research to come indoors.